Good evening, the state television company Western Armenia presents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. The road where the thickness of the snow is 4 meters was opened in Van. The Turkish embargo can only harm Armenia if. Experts' opinion. Ara Evazian and Iran ambassador discuss Azerbaijani provocative actions at border provinces of Armenia. Artsakh emergency service. Search resumes for remains of Armenian soldiers killed in war. Bahram Dumanyan took part at the declaration ceremony of Machanes Cultural Fortress City. The presentation of the picture book Ara Harutyunyan, From Komitas to Komitas at Komitas Museum Institute. The historical structures of Western Armenia. Pertek Castle of Dersim. Nubar Afeyan is one of the 9 new billionaires who became rich through vaccine production. There is already the season of beach vacation in some regions of Western Armenia, while the plateaus of Bachesaray province are just being cleared of snow. The highland roads of Bachesaray province, which are used by people engaged in agriculture and animal husbandry in summer, are still impassable due to the snow, even in May. In winter, most of the snow falls on the Sundus Plateau in Bachesaray, and sometimes the roads are closed for 6 months, which is why the place is called Ninth Planet. Now the snow removal works on the road are over and it's open for traffic. We present you the Turkish embargo can only harm Armenia if, experts' opinion article of Sputnik Armenia. The authorities must make the business understand that the embargo will last at least 3 to 4 years. Then the businesses will be more confident in investing into local production. It is not realistic to refuse Turkish raw materials yet. Even the refusal of finished goods will take time and effort. According to the results of the first quarter of 2021, the production of a number of goods that were previously imported from Turkey has increased in Armenia. But for the embargo to really help Armenia's economy, it must be guaranteed to last at least 3 to 4 years. Founder of the expert community Expert Armenia, Emil Stepanyan, spoke to Sputnik Armenia about the nuances of the Turkish embargo. Aram Gariginyan held the conversation. The full article is available on our website. Acting Foreign Minister Ara Ayvazyan on Monday received Iranian ambassador to Armenia Abbas Badakhshan Zohuri, the Minister of Defense of Armenia, informed News.am. Regional security and peace were the focus of this meeting. Reference was made of the situation in the border provinces of Armenia as a result of provocative actions of Azerbaijan. In this connection, the Armenian Foreign Minister stressed the imperative for the immediate and unconditional withdrawal of the Azerbaijani armed forces that had penetrated the sovereign territory of Armenia. The interlocutors exchanged views also on a number of issues on the Armenian-Iranian agenda, and special reference was made to the recent high-level bilateral visits being made and the course of implementation of the agreements reached as a result of these visits. The search operations are conducted from Monday in the Varandar region now under Azerbaijani control. The search was suspended since May 4. The total number of such remains found or transferred by Azerbaijan in the territories now outside Artsakh jurisdiction after the ceasefire is 1,553, and 27 of them, according to preliminary data, are of civilians. Cross of Armenia Unity Cultural Charitable NGO founded Machanes Cultural Fortress City in Eshmiadzin. The Ministry of Education, Science, Culture and Sports reports via News.am that the ceremony of declaration of Machanes Cultural Fortress City took place on May 21, to which the acting Minister of Education, Science, Culture and Sports of the Republic of Armenia, Vahram Dumanyan, and Deputy Minister Ara Khazmalyan attended. The acting minister welcomed the idea of creating a unique cultural cradle and awarded the founder of Cross of Armenian Unity organization, Grigor Machanes Babakhanyan, with the Gold Medal of RAESCS Ministry for his contribution to the development and publicity of Armenian culture, innovative and creative approaches in the framework of the event. The presentation of the picture book Ara Harutyunyan, From Komitas to Komitas, took place at Komitas Museum Institute. The national artist of Armenia, prominent sculptor monumentalist Ara Harutyunyan's sculptures, drawings and sketches dedicated to Komitas, which were presented at the exhibition in the museum, are included in the book. Ara Harutyunyan's oldie Komitas covers were presented in the book for the first time. There are some works from the family and private collections, as well as from the collection of the National Gallery of Armenia. The 2,800-year-old Pertek Castle, built on a hill at the period of Ararat Kingdom in the province of Dersim, Western Armenia, has taken on the appearance of an island, creating a unique view with the background of the blue water, and is on its way to becoming a center of temptation. The Pertek Fortress, built by the Urartians in the BC 8th century on a hill on the banks of the Arazan River, was submerged in 1974 due to the creation of the Keban Dam and took the form of an island. The castle, which is one of the most important values in the province of Pertek since the Ararat Kingdom, has hosted the Persians, the Hellenes, Rome and other civilizations. The 2,800-year-old castle consists of two walls, and the ruins of a building are between the walls. Reservoir ruins are located between the red and durable blue tiles of red bricks located between the polished stones. The location of the historical fortress is such that the Harbert fortress in Harbert, the Sagma fortress built in the same Pertek province, face each other. Pertek is one of the pearls of Western Armenia. It is definitely worth seeing. Dear compatriots, we recommend you to visit this historical miracle. At least 9 people have become new billionaires since the beginning of the COVID-19 pandemic thanks to the excessive profits made by pharmaceutical companies producing its vaccines. Business Insider reports, referring to the People's Vaccine Alliance. Valurer.am informs, the list of billionaires includes a number of scientists as well as the heads of large pharmaceutical companies such as Moderna, CanSino Biologics and Biotech. According to a report using data from Forbes, there are 9 new billionaires who have accumulated their wealth for the production of vaccines. Moderna President Noubar Afeyan, whose fortune is currently estimated $1.9 billion, is also on the list of billionaires. Now I present you Sahak Sahakyan Soskum Nahavur. The full version is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.